Hi everybody, this is Janine here, and I wanted to take time this week to share a website that I really enjoy going on, not just for myself, but for my students to do as well. And this website is called Zooniverse, zooniverse.org. The link is listed below. In Zooniverse, this is a website in which you can participate in different scientific research projects, even if you're not a professional scientist. And as you scroll down here, you can see there's a lot of different things here to participate in. But the place I really want to show you is in projects. So if you click on projects and you scroll down, you can see there are lots of different types of subjects that you can participate in. So for me, being a science teacher and one who loves astronomy, I go right to the space ones. And if you scroll down here, you can see there are lots of different projects you can participate in. Don't forget to look at the second page as well. But I've done Planet 4, I've done Supernova Hunters, and I'm going to back out here and I want to show you this one. This one's called Mapping Historic Skies, and I really like this one because it directly relates to my channel, helping to identify constellations. So let's go take a look at that one. All right, so now I want to sign into Zooniverse. And if you are interested in this opportunity to participate in citizen science, I encourage you to register, and then what this will do is keep track of all the classifications you've done over time. So when I flip here, you can see this is my avatar here, and it's telling me how many classifications I've made over the years. And you can scroll and hover over these different colored bars, and it'll tell you which ones you have participated in. So this one is a plankton one I really like, and Galaxy Zoo is another one I've done a lot of. But the project I want to share with you is called, let's go to projects, and I'm going to go to astronomy or space. And the one I wanted to share with you today is called Mapping Historic Skies. And this helps researchers identify constellations on different celestial maps. And I thought, this is perfect. I have to share this with people on my channel because it would give you an opportunity to check it out. And I'm really surprised at how fast this project is getting completed. So when I first checked this out, or I found it about a week ago, it was, you know, the bar was down here at like 7%, and now it's all the way up to 77%. So I'd love for you guys to jump on and learn a little bit more about this project so you can help contribute to scientific research. You can learn about the projects by clicking on About, and it tells you about the research, the team, different publications about it, and FAQs. But the meat of these projects really happens in the Classify button. So when you click Classify, you are asked to complete a task. And here it's asking me, do I know the name of this constellation? And before you even begin the tasks, it's a really good idea to take a look at the tutorial. And this will walk you through what you need to do for this particular project. And every project has its own tutorial. Some tasks are really quick and you can go through them, like the plankton ones. That's why I've done so many of them, is because it's really easy to do. Galaxy Zoo is one that's really easy for me to go through, but some are a little bit more elaborate. So for this one, it says, do you know the name of this constellation? And I do. It looks like Pegasus. I can see the name right here. I can see it's really close to Cygnus as well, and Andromeda's right here. So I would say, yes, I know the name, and I would write Pegasus. Sometimes the maps here are in a different language, so I just write the words that I see. But if you have a question about it, you can always, right here, ask, you know, click on this and you can ask some questions and somebody will reply back to you. This task isn't quite finished because it says, do you think the box drawn around the constellation needs to be reviewed? Well, does the crop need to be adjusted? Well, there's not much more they can do here. And does it include multiple constellations? It doesn't. So you can say done and talk about it and ask some questions, or you can just say done. So here is another one. Do I know the name of this constellation? I have to turn my head. It looks like a fish of some sort. I'm going to say that this would be Pisces, or at least a part of Pisces, for two reasons. One, Pisces is located right next to Pegasus in the sky, and you can kind of see that it looks like there's a little rope around this tail. So I would say, yes, I know the name of it, and I'm going to say it's Pisces. And I don't think this constellation crop up needs adjustment to better match the constellation. I would say yes. It's a little too small because it doesn't include the entire constellation. And then I would say done. So that's how this project works. And I also want you to notice that right here is this blue bar of announcements. So this will give you some updates on the project as it goes. I've also noticed that when I do it on my phone, the tasks look a little different. But whenever I work on Zooniverse, I pretty much work off my computer desktop because it's just easier to see. So I encourage you to explore Zooniverse. There are so many different projects that you can participate in, and it doesn't just have to be about space, although I'm very partial to that subject. There's plenty of other subjects you can look at as well. I spend a lot of time in the biology ones because I am also a biology teacher, so it makes sense for me to spend some time there. But in terms of the ones with astronomy, I really, really love Galaxy Zoo. And I enjoy, here's Galaxy Zoo as well. I've done Solar Storm Watch, but there's just a lot to look at, and you can help just get a glimpse into what different research, what is the research that's going on out there right now. And this is a really big help to many scientists out there. So thanks so much for watching. I hope this was really interesting for you to learn a little bit more about. And remember, just keep going outside. It takes time, practice, and patience to study the sky. And it's something that humans have been doing for thousands of years. And you can help participate in the Sky Watcher project to help other scientists. And I will see you guys next week. Take care.